Yeah, thanks. Thanks very much for that. Yeah, Minister, look, this is a part of the world that both Senator McGahon and I represented on Louth County Council in the Dundalk-Carlingford area, and it's a hugely symbolic and important project for the communities of O'Meath, Carlingford, North Louth, but also communities on the other side of the border, like Warren Point, Ross Trevor, Newry. And it's really a symbolic thing where we're connecting those two communities that have been apart for so long because of various issues and the troubles and everything else. The Carlingford Lock is already quite connected already through the likes of the Carlingford Ferry at the mouth of the lock, which goes from Greenore over to Greencastle, and this is a good way to connect it further down. It's very much symbolic. It has had so many false hopes and so many false dawns over the year, and indeed, when I was first elected to the council in 2014, it was so, so close to getting over the line, but because of mistakes and prices and tenders, it fell short. We now have a situation where the project is literally shovel ready. It could start tomorrow if the funding was approved, and we need government to approve that funding. And the funding actually, I suppose, is there through the Shared Island unit. The Shared Island unit are looking around to fund projects at the same time that are ready to start. So this is the perfect example of something that we can do with it. And that's why myself and Senator McGahon are bringing that to the Senate today. We just need the final approval and the rubber stamp from government to go ahead with it. And it would be remiss of me not to mention the late councillor Tommy Elmore. Tommy Elmore put this project on the map 40 years ago. He was the first person who advocated this. The Elmore family are synonymous with the O'Meath community, and I think it would be remiss of me not to mention Tommy today, who passed away nearly 2.5 decades ago, but this was his project. He was the first one that started talking about this. He put it on the map 40 years ago when the concept of cross-border infrastructure was null and void because people were blowing stuff like that up. And I would really like to remember his memory today in this very important debate about the Narrow Water Bridge.
Thank you, Senator McGahon. Minister, you have 4 minutes.
Just to thank you for putting the case so well, not just about the physical infrastructure, but the symbolism of the bridge as a bridging between two communities. Just to say, unfortunately, Mr. Ryan or Mr. Nocton are not available, so I'm taking this topic on their behalf. It is important to note from the start that there is a government commitment to jointly with the Northern Irish Executive progress consideration of options for the development of the Narrow Water Bridge project and the North-South at the North-South Ministerial Council, included in a new decade, new approach. This followed on from a similar commitment in a fresh start, the Stormont Agreement and Implementation Plan. A progress report regarding consideration of options for a Narrow Water Bridge was considered by the North-South Ministerial Council in July 2016, and the Council decided then that work should continue on the development of options. Senior officials have been continuing a review of these options, which has included meetings with relevant stakeholders. In engaging with stakeholders, officials have highlighted the need to assess all potential options objectively to ensure that the best possible outcome for the area and the best use of public funds. Following on from that, the Department of Infrastructure Northern Ireland started work on the preparation of an outline business case regarding a narrow water bridge scheme. The purpose of the business case is to consider the need to construct a bridge over the Newry River and appraise options to ensure any proposal put forward is likely to represent value for money. The Department's Strategic Research and Analysis Division provided input into this work. The proposal for the Narrow Water Bridge does have to be considered in light of welcome developments in the respect of the Newry Southern Relief Road since 2016. The Newry Southern Relief Road would provide an alternative route for strategic traffic that avoids Newry city centre and link the eastern seaboard, A1, N1 to Belfast and Dublin, key transport corridor. The Department for Infrastructure has conducted a community consultation on the Newry Southern Relief Road regarding the preferred route. The current proposal for the Newry Southern Relief Road is likely to include pedestrian cycling provision as well as connectivity to the B79 R173 Fathom Lane leading to Omeath Carlingford. I understand that the intention is for a complete stage 3 scheme assessment of the Newry Southern Relief Road to be published in Q3 of this year by the Department of Infrastructure. As part of the project optioneering, I understand that 4 options are being considered for the Narrow Water Bridge, i.e. do nothing, a pedestrian cycle bridge only, a bridge that also caters for cars, and a bridge which also caters for buses, coaches and HGVs. The overall assessment of the case for the Narrow Water Bridge, including in the context of the development of a wider tourism initiative for the region, is not at a stage which is clearly defined and costed scheme Further consideration of any impact of the R173 of any vehicular bridge would also need to be considered. The North-South Ministerial Council on the 5th of May 2021 noted the commitments in New Decade, New Approach in relation to the Narrow Water Bridge and agreed that departments will consider the next steps to progress the scheme. I understand at a meeting Minister Ryan committed to meeting with stakeholders in the area with Minister Mallon once COVID restrictions permitting such a visit are lifted. The options for the Narrow Water Bridge remain under consideration.
Just to follow on for that, Minister, I don't think it should be a case of the Newry Southern Relief Road or the Narrow Water Bridge. There's no reason why we can't have both. Obviously, there's great reasons why the Newry Southern Relief Road makes sense in terms of vehicle traffic and access and all of that, but it shouldn't be a case of one or the other. And as Senator McGahon rightly pointed out, this is the symbolic nature we have to talk about. And that's why this project has been progressed through the Shared Island Unit, as opposed to, say, a Department of Transport or an infrastructure side of things.
Thank you, Senator McGahon. Minister.
To the Senators, I understand the frustration regarding progress on this topic, and it is of great importance on both sides of the border, as has been stated. There are many moving parts in achieving progress on this issue. The development of the Newry Southern Relief Road, as I mentioned in my opening statement, is proceeding well, and this would have a major impact on the robustness of any business case that would subsequently be developed for a vehicular narrow water bridge. It is likely that many of the benefits in the business case that would originally have accrued to a vehicular bridge at Narrow Water will instead flow to the Newry Southern Relief Road instead. To that end, cycling and walking bridge of a real architectural merit is worthy of consideration. This could tie in with natural beauty of Carlingford Lock. It would link the Newry to Greenway and create the impetus for a greenway on the northern side of the lock from Warren Point to Greencastle, where greenway users could use the ferry to journey across the Greenore, would perhaps be worthy of consideration and provide a world-class piece of tourism infrastructure in the region that would bring huge benefits to the people on both sides of the border. We have seen the transformation of towns like Newport and Mayo, Kilmacthomas and Dungarvan and Waterford after greenways are developed, and brings hundreds of thousands of users to the area of the country where in much need of tourism. Greenways provide that as well as providing means of connecting our towns and villages with a sustainable means of transport for everyday journeys by foot or bicycle. However, this is just one option and all options are on the table for consideration. I understand that officials are continuing to work on devising costs for all the options as well as the wider impact of other developments in the area. I look forward to visiting the region soon. I'm due to visit in the next number of weeks and hopefully we'll meet in that regard and discuss it further.
Thank you.